for beginning the task of adopting a WECS ordinance that will protect the interests of our county. Our current ordinance gives voice, but not substance, to items that should never change as listed in section 9 of our current ordinance. It says, the purpose of the ordinance is to assure that wind-generated electricity is safe in Henry County. The intent of the regulations is to preserve health, safety, and general welfare of the public. So it is our hope that the intent and purpose of the revised ordinance will be strengthened with real protections and not weakened to improve wind company profitability. Blade failure is the most common accidents with wind turbines, closely followed by fire. There are thousands of blade failures every year worldwide, many failures every day. Wind companies and pro-wind interests claim it will not happen here. It will not happen to me, and it will not happen to you. Safety experts will tell you that such attitudes and claims are a recipe for disaster. One principle of safety is that hazard can be mitigated by enforcing common sense standards. In short, don't put people in a situation where they could be hurt. Commissioners need to protect the interests of their constituents, not the pocketbooks of big wind corporation. Resident safety and welfare must be the heart and soul of county regulation. In the history of wind debate in Henry County, three proposals have been made to weaken the purpose and intent of the WECS ordinance by shortening setbacks. One was by Mr. Duggar, one by Mr. Llanos, one by Apex. From a safety standpoint, that makes about as much sense as a screen door on a submarine. Wind company personnel are the experts on their installations and are intently aware of windmill dynamics and capabilities. At the Apex Public Safety meeting, I asked the Apex Corporate Safety Manager what the blade throw distance of the proposed turbines is. He looked me in the eye and lied. He stated he did not know. No one from Apex seemed to have any clue what it could be. All they were certain of was that their proposal for a 1,200-foot setback to a residence is safe. Throw distance information is not to get out as far as wind companies are concerned. You wonder why that is? Potentially, 1,200 feet is in the kill zone. Could it be that if the citizens of the county became aware of that safety problem, they would not want to live where a blade could come crashing through their roof? Do you think that if the company that installed the Shenandoah turbine let it get out, that the high school, the elementary school, and the football field are all in the windmill blade throw radius, the project would have gone forward with such a short setback? Our current ordinance failed the county miserably. The authorities that put it there knew or should have known better, but they didn't give a damn. They've been lucky so far. Accidents may not happen. They occur randomly. As time goes on and the machine starts to fatigue and disaster strikes, there will be hell to pay. To add insult to injury, there will be lawyers to pay. For safety's sake, in the revised ordinance section for application requirements, section 9.6 in our existing ordinance, please require wind companies to certify the throw distance of the proposed turbines when applying for commission-approved use. All of us have the right to know. For safety's sake, in the setback section of the new ordinance, prohibit siting a turbine closer to a structure than the blade throw distance as an absolute minimum. We are currently in a dry part of the year. You can see how dry it is. Crops are drying in the field. These industrial wind turbines will be sitting in the middle of a tinderbox. When fire occurs, it will travel at a tremendous velocity. The manufacturer of all of these machines state that a 2,500-foot perimeter should be established to keep people away. People have feet and can move. Homes do not. We need need to follow the manufacturer's recommendation. Keep structures a minimum of 2,500 foot from the machine. Once again, wind engineers say, don't worry, it won't happen here. It will not happen to you. With the ordinance we have proposed yesterday with Roslyn, with common sense regulation and setbacks, disaster will not happen here, and harm will not come to any in Henry County from these huge industrial machines. So we look forward to seeing your positive action in this ordinance revision.